The intersection of the money demand and the money supply gives a short-run interest rate. Why? Because any interest rate above this, money supply will be higher than money demand. Then there'll be more people willing to supply money than demanding money. Now, so think about this. If I'm a bank and I want people to hold on to more money, I must lower the interest rate. If not, people will find it too expensive to hold on to money because interest rate is the price of holding on to money. So I lower interest rate and the quantity of money demanded increases and we move towards the equilibrium. Now let's think about the other scenario where money demand is higher than the money supply. If money demand is higher than money supply, then there will be lots of people queuing outside the bank to withdraw money. How do I convince these people that it is not worth their time? So by increasing the interest rate. So interest rate increases and less people queue outside the bank, and eventually no one queues outside the bank, we reach a new equilibrium. Hence, the intersection of money demand and money supply gives us the short-term interest rate. Now, if central bank moves its money supply by changing the amount of money in circulation, interest rate changes. For the A-level syllabus, you're not required to know how the money supply changes, but we know you're interested. So in the last lecture of this topic, we included a special checkpoint about manipulation of money supply. In that checkpoint, we explain the mechanisms through which the central bank change the money supply. Now, do watch that if you're interested in the money supply, but for now, let's assume that the central bank can manipulate the money supply. Then changes in money supply causes changes in interest rate. But why do I use the term short-term interest rate? To understand the distinction between short-term and long-term interest rates, we actually need to define long-term interest rate first, and then we'll find out the difference between short-term and long-term interest rates.